The precise lunar orbit insertion maneuver carried out at 9 o'clock for about 30 minutes precisely injected the Chandrayaan 2 in a defined orbit in a perfect way. As we are aware, in order to achieve the required location for soft landing near South Pole, our Chandrayaan 2 have a unique requirement which other countries not have. That is to achieve the moon orbit with the inclination of 90 degrees. This is a unique requirement only Chandrayaan has, which no other moon mission has. That is, this particular requirement of 90 degrees is achieved by the precise execution of TLI and LOI maneuvers. And now, the Chandrayaan 2 is going around the moon in an orbit of 114 kilometer perihelion and 18,000 kilometer aphelion with the inclination of 88 degrees. In a due course, this orbit will be brought down near to 100 by 100 and then further by 100 by 30, and at that time the inclination of the orbit also will achieve 90 degrees, so that we will achieve the mission of the power descent. Friends, subsequent to the launch of Chandrayaan 2 on July 22nd, the five orbit, the earthbound maneuvers happened on Chandrayaan 2 to raise its orbit to the altitude of something like 141,000 kilometer. Then on 19th, around 14th August, 2:21 a.m., the very important maneuver, the translunar injection, it's happened, by which the Chandrayaan 2 was injected towards moon with a velocity of 10.9 kilometers per second, which sends the Chandrayaan 2 to an apogee altitude of 418,000 kilometer, which is 7,000 kilometer above the moon orbit. And at the apogee point, the velocity of the vehicle or Chandrayaan 2 is something like 0.1 kilometer per second. In order to show or tell you the importance of the translunar injection accuracy or precision, just I want to tell, out of 10.9 kilometer per second, in case there is a dispersion of 10 centimeter per second velocity difference, that will end up with the orbital inclination of the at the moon will be away by 7 degrees. We will not be able to meet the requirement of meeting the soft landing at the South Pole. This is the type of accuracy we are talking. And once this the Chandrayaan 2 travels towards the apogee point, then when it is the returned back from the apogee point, yesterday, 19th, around 3 p.m., the moon also gone near to the Chandrayaan 2. Then Chandrayaan 2 was entered into the sphere of influence of moon. And from that time onwards, the Chandrayaan 2 was under the influence of the gravity of the moon, and Chandrayaan, the speed started increasing due to the gravity of the moon. If you are leaving as it is, the velocity will be the further build up and Chandrayaan 2 will escape from the earth. So in order to ensure the Chandrayaan 2 go around the moon. That is the exact the purpose of the lunar orbit insertion maneuver. In order to reduce that the velocity of the Chandrayaan 2 from 2.4 km per second to 2.1 km per second, the lunar orbit insertion maneuver was carried out today. In this process, the Chandrayaan 2 is going around the moon with an elliptical orbit of 114 km by 18,000 km. If the lunar orbit insertion maneuver is not proper, then also the orbit of the Chandrayaan 2 will be improper, and we may not get back the Chandrayaan 2. That is the importance of the lunar orbit insertion maneuver. Now come back. After now achieving that the important maneuver, the lunar orbit insertion maneuver, what next? We are going to have the four more lunar burn. We are going to have the next one will be tomorrow by around 1 o'clock. Then we have three more maneuvers. That is 28th and 30th and the 1st September. By this process, the orbit of the Chandrayaan 2 will be reduced from 18,000 km to something like 100 km by 100 km circular orbit around the moon by 1st September. Then the major event, next major event is happening on 2nd September, wherein the lander will be separated from the orbiter. Till now, the entire operations are carried out by the propulsion systems from the orbiter. And from September 2nd onwards, the entire attention will be towards lander. That is, lander will be separated from the orbiter. It is like the bridegroom is separated from the parents' house. Now it will be entering into the bride's house, this one. That way it is separated. And then onwards, the operation will be on the lander. What really happening is, on 3rd, we would be having a small maneuver, retro deorbit maneuver for about 3 seconds to ensure whether the systems in the lander are normal. After confirming the normalcy of the system, then 4th September, we will be doing the real deorbit maneuver at lander for about 6.5 seconds. In that maneuver, the lander will be put in an orbit of 35 km perigee and about 97 km apolur, not perigee, perilune, 35 km perilune and 97 km apolune. That way the lander will be there on 4th. Next 3 days, we will be checking the various parameters of the lander to ensure that everything is on right, and to check and verify once again the system perfectly all right. Once we are confirming the system health is all right, on 7th early morning, 1:40, the powered descent starts. And next 15 minutes at 1:55, the lander will be landing at a site 71 degrees south of equator, moon's equator, with a 22.8 degree east. It is between two craters called Mancinus C and Symplebius N. Between these craters, the thing will be landing. After landing on the lunar surface, 2 hours later, the ramp in the the lander will come down and touch the ground. And then 3 hours, 10 minutes later, the solar panel of the rover will be deployed. And the 3 hours, 50 minutes, the lander will start move from the rover will start from the lander. And at 4 hours, the lander will be touching on the moon surface. This is our plan, and I'm sure that the precision with which our LOI and the TLI we have carried out, I'm sure that we will be able to achieve the successful landing on moon on 7 by 155. That is our the plan, and I'm for this purpose that I want all your support for encouraging us and giving more and more good words, so that we'll have more energy for that. That's what I want. I would like to convey to all of you. This one.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for capturing the complexity, in essence, of the mission. And now it is open to the interaction with Chairman. Kindly first tell your name and the media house you represent. Then you ask the question. While he is answering the question, don't interrupt. Please wait for some time. So, yes, Nagar.
I'm from India today. Will the Prime Minister be on the spot on 1:55 a.m. on September 7 to witness the landing?
That we sent an invitation to Prime Minister.
Has he confirmed, sir?
No, that Prime Minister. The Prime Minister, this will be coming only last minute, the program.
How is it that you are still able to reach the destination on 6th or 7th September as earlier planned?
No, that is basically that is the, not the making of the time. It is the trajectory. We wanted to reach the moon. We are planning such that we are not losing any time. This one, I mean, we are not miss the moon. That is the way we got. It is the apogee, the burn, that is a 5 Earth burns, as well as the translunar injection times, were planned at the same time. Along with that our lunar bound burns are also planned. All these the main burns are planned such that it is maintained. There is the 7th September. Yes, we are 7th September is specifically. This is the starting of the day of the moon, so that we don't want to miss this one.
Requirement of the lander to land on a flat surface, and what are the tests being conducted by the lander before landing?
Now, this the criticality of landing will come. We have many things, like suppose this lander is landing on a inclined surface, then what will happen is it will get toppled. So this the slope of the landing surface should be less than 12 degree. If it's more than 12 degrees, the whole thing will topple. And suppose the one leg is the sitting on a boulder, then also that the toppling will be there. So this the region where we have selected, it is having that slopey region less than 12 degrees. So that ensure that it is the relatively plain surface. And boulders are also less. That way.
So at what point is the decision taken to land?
Now that is in the power descent starts, and from that time onwards, the entire thing will be decided by the Chandrayaan to lander only. That we don't have anything to hand this one. when the lander is coming down, it will take that image of the place. And it will compare with the image whatever we already stored on board, this one. and it will find wherever that the plane surface, it will look for, it will retarget, and it will hover for some time, and it will decide where to land, and then it will land. So everything will be the autonomously carried out in an intelligent way on board.
Just a moment.
Which one? That is a 1:40 a.m. on 7th.
And sir, you had mentioned that the first pictures will probably be available 20 minutes after landing. So we would expect that, around...
No. That is what we are thinking is this whale landing itself. That is when the lander is coming down. And at one point it will be coming normal to the surface of the moon. That time itself the picture will be available. And it will be the moon picture as seen by the lander will be available. After landing, then that when the rover is coming out also, that the image of the rover will be taken by this one. The clear picture of the lander and rover will be available by around 6.5 hours, I mean the 5.5 hours after landing.
Yeah, please. Sir, here. I'm asking from DDU. Sir, you said that 15 minutes time is a terrifying moment.
Yes.
Are you less terrified now because now that 60% of journey is complete? So do you think now you're more confident about, overcoming this terrifying moment? Do you still tell them as the terrifying moment?
Now that the tension is now more increased only, not reduced. No, it is like we when you are coming near to that burn, that our heartbeat used to increase, and the 30 minutes our heart was almost stopping today, till it is completing the job, this one. And even though we got successful the lunar orbit insertion today, but still that the landing is a terrifying moment. The reason is, till now that our lander systems are not operated, especially the propulsion system. It will come only after the second. Then only we will be knowing that one. And the way we are called the terrifying moment is, that is a phase where we are doing first time. Whereas that today's the lunar orbit insertion, like TLI or lunar orbit insertion, or we have already done once this one. Whereas the powered descent, whatever we are planning from on September 7th, that is the first to us, this one. That way still that the criticality is there. See, if you are seeing that, if you are just looking at what really happened to the world missions, the soft landing, and if you are seeing that soft landing, the success rate is only about 37% of the whatever missions launched. But we have the confidence about our landing mission. We are confident that because we have done enough tests, enough simulations, and all the subsystem level, system level, sensor level, the thruster level, that all the simulations we have done, we are confident that whatever humanly possible, we did this one. But at the same time, still be a new mission, that we always feel that it is a very, very terrifying moment for us. Yes, it's a new to us, first time, this one.
Kindly speak to the mind properly, no? Because it is not captured properly. Please.
Sir, could you tell us the sense of the idea of what goes on in the control room when you are doing the landing, when the landing is happening,
No, everybody's the eyes will be glued to the console. And only thing is that because of the advanced technologies, this the telemetry parameters will be seeing, and by continuously seeing these parameters, some parameters by itself will be showing that it is we are in the right direction. This type of feeling we will get. So at same time, what going to be the next moment? That anxiety also will be there. So it will be a mixed feeling of that, the happiness and the tension and more anxiety that will be there.
Yes, sir. Yes, Mishra, please.
Well, congratulations, Rajiv Mishra from Rajasthan. Sir, as we know that the distance between Earth and Moon is variable. So how far Moon will be at the time of landing, if you have any calculation? And the second thing, as we know that the all payloads are indigenous. But for as far as the analysis of data is concerned, is there any collaboration with any other agency or any other country? As far as data is concerned,
see, this you are right, there is a moon orbit, will be like a continuously varying orbit. That is, it is not perfectly the circle. And actually, this the lunar orbit insertion, whatever we are talking, this is this has happened at the almost that maximum distance from the Earth, this one. That way, I would say that when the really landing is happening, moon will be that the shortest distance place. It will be there. This is the thing.
And the data analysis,
that is whatever that the payload, the data, whatever the we have given, we have already the payload flying. That is, we have calibrations, and it is calibrated, and with that one, we are showing that, we ensure that the data is the proper this one. It's mainly that calibrated data will be used for that one.
Sir, apart from Chandrayaan, I want to ask one question. On other projects like SSLV, the house is going on, can we have a launch of SSLV in the year, or when we are returning to the launch pad?
Now, this SSLE work is going with the full steam, and we are targeting for this December launch, this one. We are targeting, because whenever our ISRO is talking, we are always with a target, with the reality maybe slightly away, this one.
Dr. Sivan?
1 minute. One minute, I will
finish. Dr. Sivan, Pallav Bhagwan from NDTV in the branch, please. In Chandrayaan 1, when the moon impact probe went down, the MIP, some of the calibrations had not been done. In Chandrayaan 2, have we ensured that all the calibrations and degassing which was necessary has been completed so that the global community can be happy with the standards we have followed?
Yes, that is till now that's what we have done. I told that all calibrations we have done. And we are we expect that the whatever problem faced in that earlier, it will not repeat. So that's a lesson we learned, so that we have taken care.
We'll go back, sir. Please.
Sir, you were mentioning that the success ratio as far as soft landing is concerned is 37%. What different are we doing to ensure that the chances of soft landing are much higher than the other countries in the world?
Now, one good thing is that we are learning from their failure. That is that itself is a lesson. So whatever that, so that lesson adding more and more valuable addition to that our system, so that we will not have such a similar problem. Another one is that is the earlier to now, the technological growth is very large in terms of the navigation system and the guidance system, and also that the entire onboard the sensor system, better systems are there, and because of technological growth, And so we are to ensure that the such type of developments happen, and we have verified and checked and simulated and ensured everything is right.
Yes.
Then,
Rashid, please.
Yeah,
this is
a related question to that. Because
Israel had a similar program and they failed in the last maneuver. What lessons has ISRO learned from the Israel failure?
No, there is mainly that that we have learned about the sensor characterization. That is the one thing we learned from there. And also that is another lesson we learned is we have to make it more and more autonomy, and we should not have a ground control when the descent is made. In order to avoid the false the decision, and better characterize the entire system in a nice way, and put it into the machine. So that will be a better thing. This is the lesson we learned.
Yeah.
Sandhya Ramesh from the Kent here. Is the rover also expected to be autonomous? And can you also tell us what the communication delay will be between the Earth and the Moon?
And lander is not totally autonomous because it is the power is very less. So it will be always depending on rover is not autonomous, the power is less. And it will be always depending on the lander. And it will be communicate only to lander. Lander, in turn, will be communicate to the Earth.
And what is the time difference in communication between Earth and the Moon?
That will be in one way is around one second also. It's very small, because it is a thing.
Oh, yeah, please.
So,
good
afternoon.
Sachin
Ravikumar
here
from Reuters. Could you talk about some of the expectations from the payloads? Yeah? I mean, ISRO has said that we will carry out water studies and also try to judge the age of the solar system and things like that. But what are some of the other key and major scientific objectives that we have pursued through the payload?
Now, from the payloads, there is we have the systems, the payload systems we have kept in the orbiter. And some of the payloads we kept on the lander and something on the rover. And mainly this is going to look into that the rock forming elements, the mapping of the rock forming elements like magnesium, aluminium, calcium, iron. That is one type of study. Another one is mapping of minerals and water is yet another the study. Then yet another scientific study, what we are looking for is the study of the exosphere. Because even though the atmosphere is not there, very, very mild atmosphere is expected. Even that one, what is the impact? That is a study. Then when the place where our lander is landing, what is that the seismic activity? That is our one thing. Then yet another the thing is that is after lander is the landing that is your probe will go inside the inserted into the lunar surface and study what are the thermal characteristics and thermal conductivity and this type of things also studied. And they can mainly the surface the chemistry, minerals, these things are there.
So what are some of the scientific applications of once you get the data for
yes, yes. That is now you know. See, that is already that, very interestingly. That is whatever the entire globe is waiting for our data, because we are going to land at a place the first time near South Pole, and already that NASA has announced that the project of having the human habitat type of thing near South Pole. Because South Pole is expected to have more water, more minerals, because of special characteristics of the South Pole. So this will be giving a feedback or the input for the future program, which the humanity is considering in a major way, especially that the NASA and all. They tweeted, you are going to land in the place where we are going to land after some time, man. So that way, this will give a main input to the science, input to that project.
Thank you.
Harish from UZ.